Nothing's better than family for the ones who love you so. Be a shoulder to cry on when you're in need. They'll never leave you alone, no.
When your friends bring you down
and they drag you through the dirt, girl.
And when nobody's around,
they'll carry you through the hurt. Just remember.
Go on and complain.
No, what I'm saying is, if I come to church early and if I sit on the end of the pew, that's where I want to sit. And I don't like it when they come and make you move over, because that's where I want to sit. So you just want to ask me to move over is usually for her mom. That's how I move over.
Whose mom?
Her mom.
Who's mom?
Olive oil's mom. Popeye's
Who,
wife.
Who's that? Oh, I'll put a name to it.
Olive oil.
Don't do that.
I'll put a name to it
don't
then.
Don't do that. That's
and
not
so
right.
You call it olive oil, so that then they'll look at you and say, I didn't even think that you would even do that.
No, I just picked
that's
a
just like a, that's just like a that's just like a Jane Doe type name.
Yeah.
What, olive oil?
Yeah, it goes to John Doe, Jane Doe, and olive oil.
No,
yeah.
No.
And baby olive oil.
Yeah.
I got one got football.
That's how we do like with our friends and stuff. Like, okay, you go get the skirt first and see how I look on you, and then I go get it.
Yeah, I know that same thing you're talking about backfired on some girl I knew.
Oh, yeah.
It backfired on her. Yep.
That's how me and my friends say we was going to dress alike. And I go to school with blue jeans on and a red shirt, and they come with blue jeans on and a green shirt. It's going to make me mad. Supposed to be dressing
like,
and then I stopped doing it. I just became my own person. And what I wanted.
When? When
does
this happen? When
does
this happen?
What size is it so tiny?
4 and a half.
That's like a baby finger.
Wait a minute. When I went to get my size, the lady goes, how about a 5? I say it's too big. How about 5 and a half? I say it's too small. 5 and a fourth.
Are you? 5 and a fourth. Wow. Yeah, that's right in between.
I'm a 6, straight 6.
Gorgeous. And this lady told me to keep the baguettes. I don't know what you want to do, but you can always take it back to the jeweler. But she said half ammonia, half water.
Mm-hmm.
So I haven't tried it. Yeah.
The jewelry thing I got has something ammonia in it.
It does.
You can smell it when you open it up, it has something ammonia in it. It's called Magic Gold.
You're not going to take it off to work out, are you?
No. My skirt's loose, that could be a sign.
You're not going to take your ring off to work out, are you?
If you're a man, you would.
Women work out too, lifting weights and everything.
So wait a minute. So what you're saying is men, when they go to work out, they are ringless?
Or they put it in their locker.
They walk around with their fingers ringless?
Yes.
Like they're single or something?
No, they ain't got nothing to do with it. They ain't single. Once they married, the ring don't make you married. The ring don't do anything.
It's the symbol.
No, it's a symbol. That's all it is, a symbol.
That's right.
But it's a sacred symbol. It's not just a
symbol. It's just like those nines, the world's habits.
Well, you know what? Now they wear rings. They wear rings.
Oh, they don't wear habits no more? They wear rings?
Yeah, they wear a ring. And that ring symbolizes they're married to Jesus.
Okay, so they don't wear habits no more.
Well, some of them do. Some of the old saints don't wear their arms out. Same thing. Some people follow the tradition and some
Don't. Like today, one old saint didn't wear her arm out.
Yeah, this old saint did not wear her arm out because we're in 100-degree weather, and she wants me to be out in 100-degree weather with my arms out, and I tell her all the time I get burned really bad, so I had a long, sweet t-shirt
on. But she
had
this long, sweet t-shirt, and it was cotton. It was cotton.
That was just cotton.
Off season on the way home, I was like, you and your wool shirt.
I didn't itch.
But she was sweating like she just ran around the block, though.
I'm trying to figure this one out. Help me out, young folks, because I can't understand this. Why is it that the young people pick at us when we wear things, but we can't pick at them when they wear things?
Yeah, I do figure that. You just gonna come down and look at what she got on. She know her tail too big. Y'all be talking to me here, yeah.
I'm just trying to figure this out. Then she told me what to wear. She told me, don't wear your black jeans, because black is hot. Wear your faded ones.
I say you're stonewashed.
Oh, stonewashed. Like, stonewashed. Big stonewashed jeans.
But weren't you comfortable?
And I'm constantly pulling them up.
But weren't you comfortable?
Yes, I was. Because I had my long sleeve shirt on.
If the sun was blazing down the back of my neck and then my mama walked past me, I was like,
girl. Well, see, I'm going to be nice. I'm going to be real nice.
Okay. Okay, Oscar. Okay. You want me to take some of you?
Yeah. Okay.
See you, Ronette. See ya. Annette, do you have your key? Okay, baby, let's
So nobody wants to talk to me.
Everybody.
Nobody wants to give me the time of day. But I am a person who can get within myself. And I know that I am somebody.
Hey, no.
So then I can make things around me shine, because if I let my sunshine fly out to others, then I become a source of light for others and the energy and excitement that others want to come to me. So I say, hey, let me shine my light, let me let my energy flow, hey. And I watch them come to me. Hey, ho, 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 I'm not ready yet. I'll let you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I have a woman who I'm very proud of, one who that is the center of my heart, and I tell you, it's a little bit different having someone that you know is yours and someone that you know is going to be there for you, someone that you can trust and someone that you can depend on. So, that young lady, Pat, I love you, girl.
Well, thank you, sweetie.
So, of course, I've changed a little bit in that I don't have to be all in within myself when I have her to my side, because I know now I have a light that I can cling on to. She would kind of light my way, and I'll light her way. And she would kind of like open the path for me, and I like open the path for her. We kind of like, it's like a a twin being, which become one being, which become one, which we are. We want to be one in Christ, one in body and soul. We're one. That's one. One person. Pat and Oscar. Of course, now I have a son, too. His name happened to be CJ. And this is what I have to do. I have to teach him how to be my man. But one day he's going to be too big for me to lift up. And I have to use a bit more energy to handle him. But right now, I'm the king. And I will handle him with strength. But he will always respect me.
Yep.
I don't care how big you get, you still respect me. Okay? That's all for now, ladies and gentlemen. Think I'm a good old dude?
Mm-hmm.
Think I'm fair?
Mm-hmm.
Think I'm strict?
Mm-hmm.
You think I want the best for you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, tell me that.
I don't know what to say.
Do you think I try to lead you in the right path?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think I try to tell you things that might help you?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think I treat your mama right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think I try to treat you right?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me that.
I still don't know what to say.
Huh?
I appreciate you, CJ.
Me too.
You too what?
You
appreciate you too?
Mm-hmm.
Do you appreciate me?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you tell me that?
Yes, I do.
I appreciate you. I bet I appreciate you more than you appreciate me. Hmm? Do you believe that?
Mm-hmm.
Why is that? Why don't you appreciate me more than I appreciate you?
Oh, that's what I'm about.
Huh?
That's wrong.
Huh? I bet I like you more than you like me. Hmm? You think that's true? Nope. Or you think you like me more than you like you?
Nope.
You think I like you more than I like me?
No.
Huh?
You're confusing me.
Well, straighten me out then. Straighten me out, old man.
I don't know.
You don't know what?
I don't know how to straighten you.
Okay. Tell me, who's the best player in the NBA?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What school did he go to?
Mm-hmm.
What school did he go to?
Mm-hmm.
I tell you, he wants to get back to that computer. That's his problem.
So you ain't got time for real people, do you? Yeah, but what if I tell you you have to turn the computer off?
Mm-hmm.
Then you have more time to stand and talk to me. Because mm-hmm. you wouldn't have nothing else to do. Then that's what you'd be doing. You'd be hanging around. Wouldn't you? Little man. See what you got, little man. What you got, little man. All right. Okay, that'll be it. Where you going?
Hurry up.
Hurry up. Bye. CJ is up to your shoulders now.
I am.
Well, his head is anyway.